गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, क्लास सेवेंथ फिजिकल साइंस वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड रिगार्डिंग मेजरमेंट। नाउ हियर इन लास्ट क्लास आई हैव टोल्ड यू व्हाई वी आर यूजिंग ए मेजरमेंट एंड आल्सो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड लाइक three systems we will be using to measure any object like FPS system, CGS system, MKS system, or we call it as SI system. You all remember that. Now, in order to measure any physical quantity, these three systems we are using. In FPS system, your length always we will measure in foot. Mass we will measure it in pounds. Time we will measure it in seconds. Okay? Told you this, or in your lower classes you have learned. In CGS system, we have measured length in centimeter, mass will be measured in grams, time is measured in seconds. Okay, in MKS or SI system, we will measure length in meter. Mass is measured in kilogram. Time is measured in seconds. Okay? These are some of the systems in order to measure any physical quantity. Now, in this chapter, you have first topic is measurement of area. What we need to measure? Measurement of area. Now, in mathematics, you might have learned area of a rectangle, area of a square, all these things. Today our topic is measurement of area. How to measure area? Before entering into that, we will find out a simple definition of area. What do you mean by area? Space inside the boundary of a flat surface. The space inside the boundary of a flat surface in a two-dimensional body. Space inside the boundary of a flat surface is called area. See here, this is a rectangle. Now here you have length and breadth. Now this is the boundary of your rectangle. Now inside part we will call it as area. Space inside the boundary of a flat surface is called as area. Now in mathematics we have studied area of a rectangle is L into B. What is L there? Length, base, breadth. Space inside the boundary of a flat surface is always called as area. Now, I have measured area of a rectangle as L into B. Okay? This is the boundary for your rectangle. Whatever area it has occupied can be found out by L into B. Now, here itself, we will find out the units. Units means, if suppose the length of a rectangle is 2, the breadth is 1. What does it indicate? Whether it is in centimeter or a meter, we must write the units compulsory. Hence, for length, in CGS system, how to write the units for a given physical quantity like area? Look at it. Area. First you need to write the formula. L into B. CGS. What do you mean by CGS? I have told you. Length we will always measure in CGS system as centimeter. So now, breadth, it is also the distance. Hence, breadth is also measured in CGS system as centimeter. Now, basis of same, can I add the powers? Hence, area equal to here centimeter power 1. Centimeter power 1. Hence, bases are same. 1 plus 1 is centimeter power 2. We need to read this as centimeter square. Following children, unit for area in CGS system is centimeter square or square centimeter. You can also read it like that. Okay? Now similarly, we can find out the units for area in MKS system. MKS system or SI system. That means Standard International System. Now in MKS system, again, area equal to L into B. MKS. Length, how do we measure? Meter. How do we measure breadth? Again, meter. Bases are same. Can I write M power 2? That is meter square. That is centimeter square. Units for area in CGS system is centimeter square. In MKS or SI system, it is meter square. Okay? Now here, this is a flat surface and a regular body. Now next, area of a circle, you all know, pi r square. Similarly, we can also write the units for certain physical quantities by basing on the formula. Okay? Now here we have learned for a regular body. If they are having irregular shapes, then how to find the area? Okay? In order to measure the area for an irregular body, we need to follow certain rules. First thing is, if suppose I want to find the area of a leaf, you all might have seen measurement of area of a leaf, we will find out.
Thank you.
this, you must require a graph paper. Graph paper. You might have seen the graph paper contains a very small, small squares there. Okay? Now, how to find the area of a leaf? Now, for this, first take your graph paper. This graph paper contains a boxes like this, small boxes. These small boxes will be there inside your graph paper. Yes or no? Now, place any leaf, whatever leaf you have found out, place a leaf on this graph paper. Like, I have placed my leaf on the graph paper and I have drawn a boundary. Place a leaf on the graph paper, draw the boundary of the leaf. Now, you might see the leaf has covered some boxes there. Now here, in order to find the area, you must know the formula there. Area of a leaf can be found out by 1 into number of full squares. Full squares in centimeter square plus half into number of half squares. Half squares. Plus 3/4 or more than half squares. More than half squares occupied by the leaf. Okay? After placing the leaf, what I said, number of full squares. Now, how many full squares it has occupied on the graph paper? By placing the leaf, you might be saying that it has occupied as number of full squares and number of half squares. Now, how many full squares it has occupied? You find out. If suppose in your when you have placed on the graph paper, you have observed that it has occupied 2 full squares, right? Number of full squares as 2, okay? 2 centimeter square plus half. Number of half squares means only half part of the square here leaf has occupied. How many squares you count? Like if it has occupied half squares as 1, 2, 3. 3 half squares are there, right? The number of squares plus now more than half squares. That means half of it should be more than the half part should be covered by your boundary of the leaf. If it has covered only 1 half squares are there, more than 1 half squares are there, right? 1. How many squares? More than half. How many squares it has covered? You count the number of squares there and write the number here. Okay? Following, first you find out how many full squares your leaf has occupied. The number of squares. Count the number of squares there. Next, number of half squares. Suppose you are having a square like this and your leaf has occupied only half part of your square. Count the number of squares. In this, I have taken, let us assume, only 3 half squares it has occupied. Next, what I said, more than half square. That means if suppose this is the square in your graph paper, till here your leaf has occupied, covered. All this part has been covered by your leaf. Count again the number of half, more than half squares. Write the number there. Now look at here. 1 into 2 is 2. These are the units. Okay? Plus half into 3 plus 1 is 4. 2 times. 2 plus 2 is 4. Hence your area is occupied by your leaf is 4 centimeter square. Answer children. First your formula is number of full squares. How many squares it has occupied? Plus half into number of half squares. Plus more than half squares. Now substitute. Count the number of squares using the graph paper and note down the number of squares. If you are getting 10 squares, write the number as 10. If you are getting 20, write 20. How many squares you are getting? You note down. Like this, you need to do the activity for measuring the area of a leaf. Any leaf you can take, but the formula is the same. Area of a leaf can be found out by using this formula. Okay? You get children, your homework is using a graph paper finding area of a leaf. Okay? Take a graph sheet of a paper and find out the area of a leaf by using the formula I have given. Second question is, write the units for area in CGS system and MKS system. Okay? Write the formula and write the units in CGS as well as MKS system. Okay, children. Thank you.